Welcome back, mate.
Ah, yeah.
I've missed you.
Have you? I've missed you as well, mate. I've missed the Anfield rap. I've missed cameras, missed Sean, missed everyone. I'm back, though.
Yeah, it's only been 2 days. It feels like longer, I suppose. It's been the weekend and stuff like that. 40 years old.
40 years old. Absolutely no different to 39.
Yeah, it's funny that, isn't it?
Funny that, isn't it? Just the number and all that. It's funny, one of my mates texted me yesterday, like, you know, happy birthday and all that. And then he was like, how many cliches have you heard today? You know, like, life begins at 40.
Still naughty at 40.
All that, naughty 40s. You know, what I've just said, the one, only a number, blah, blah, blah. Sound. Everyone who did say nice things, by the way, on Facebook and all that, thanks. I wasn't party to this thing that it was going on every social media, me holding a cake. but it did anyway, and I had little control over it because I was in Amsterdam and wasn't in any mood to change it.
It's a good birthday though, and it's Stone Moses of the weekend, Amsterdam for a few days, yeah. He's got a scarf.
Went on the Ajax tour, might write something about this, because I wanted an Ajax scarf for the room, so I got one. Not really Ajax colours, is it? And I thought it was all a bit strange. Like, I went in the Ajax club shop after I'd been on the Ajax club tour, and I couldn't get a red and white scarf. And I was like, isn't this the colours that you're famous for? And the whole thing was a bit weird. I'll write something on it. I will definitely write something on it, because I think about, you know, the way we have conversations about Liverpool's identity as a club and all that.
Yeah.
But, like, Ajax obviously moved, and they've got this huge ground, and it's great and all the rest of it, and it's got a roof you can close, it's massive, all them things. But, like, after tour, was a fella telling us about how quickly they can turn it from a concert venue into a football venue. Showed us some time-lapse video, which was quite interesting. But I was kind of thinking, well, what about when you won the European Cup and that? You know what I mean? What about Yari Littmanen? What about Johan Cruyff? Yeah.
Well, it wasn't there, was it? And I think that's what you do lose when... And it's like... I don't know, it's a bit like the European Union, is it? Once you leave, it's hard to go back.
Oh, see what he did there?
But, you know, it is, and I think you've got to be careful with that with a football team. It's like if Liverpool, you know, looks like they're going to stay now, but if they either move, then, you know, what do you talk about? You know,
I just thought it was weird. I mean, I thought, you know, the tour was interesting enough, but the only sort of reference across it all to winning four European Cups or whatever it is, was, oh, well, we've got these rooms in the executive lounge named after the places where we won it. It was like sand. And I think he mentioned Clive there once, and I was thinking, well, he deserves a bit bigger of a billing. Clive, well, yeah, a few of them do. Because that was interesting. That's the alternative side to this identity thing. You got loads of them working there, like Van der Sar is the head of marketing, which was a mad one, but good. Yeah. And they said that he's going to be the club president from this season. Obviously, Frank de Boer was the manager. I think Blinds Aalfeller or something like that is involved. You know, there's loads of them involved, and I quite like that aspect of it. But they need a museum or something at the end. Sort that out, Ajax. But also the scarf thing. We've just been talking off camera there. Might turn it into a thing. You know, wherever we go, we'll buy a scarf and we'll stick it up on the wall and send the scarves. Seen a few people saying, like, you know, oh, we're from LFC, whatever. Like, we've got a Seattle one up there, a Melbourne one there. If you want to send this one, there's a Sydney one, yeah. If you want to send us your club scarf, we'll stick it up. We'll try and do the whole room in scarves. How about that?
It's not that big, you know.
I know. But there's plenty of there's a wall behind this camera now, which where Sean stood, looking Shawnee, and it's empty. Not on it.
Yeah.
So we need stuff for that. And plus, our studio, our other studio where we do the podcast, it's empty, innit? But we're getting stuff for that, aren't we?
Meant to be, yeah.
Should we talk about footy?
So, yeah, you missed your Anfield Appreciation Day while you were away as well.
I did, that absolutely flew, didn't it?
Yeah, it went well.
Adidas jumped on.
Yeah, Adidas were getting involved, BBC, Paddy obviously, Power. Everyone, you name it, people getting involved in Joe Allen Appreciation Day. We didn't get a huge amount of credit for starting it, but never mind, that's not what we're in it for, you know what I mean? We just want to make the world a better place. But me, Sean and Josh did that yesterday because we were on our own, and Josh is in on Wales Spinners at the moment, and he was claiming to me yesterday that reach-wise he did the best tweet.
Oh, don't be getting like that. You know what I mean? It's a team game,
isn't
that's it?
That's what I tried to tell him, but you know what I mean? These kids, they don't get it, do they? So he was trying to tell me that this morning.
Which one was it?
Well, he nicked it from some other lad, which is a bit naughty. It was the one with Pirlo plus something else.
He caused the equation
thing, which he nicked off some other lad. But I think the other lad was all right.
Sean came up with the Stone Roses one. I like that, about where it says, you know, playing footy at, what was it? Playing footy at 5 and Stone Roses at 8 or something like that. Like that one.
Yeah, it's a good one.
But Dave Rawcliffe, who takes our pictures for that we use on the site, he told Joe Allen, didn't he, about it?
Yeah, apparently Joe Allen was a bit shocked about the whole thing, which he would be. But, I mean, that kind of leads us on, really, which was James Pearce wrote something about Joe Allen last night. He was talking about Joe Allen Appreciation Day, but he thinks it's, you know, it's more or less nailed on that he's leaving. He said there's no contract anyway, near on offer to him. He's only got a year left, and even if even if we did come up with something, he doesn't think Joe Allen's likely to sign anything because he wants to play. So after all that, it looks like he's going anyway. So
yeah, I mean, I kind of thought it might end like this because there was something out of Swansea the other week, which we talked about on the video at the time, whereby they were putting it out there quite strongly that they want him, that they can offer him first team football, that he'd play every week and all that. And I think, what is he now, 26?
26, yeah.
I think he wants that at this stage of his career, and I don't think Liverpool can offer him that, which is a bit of a shame. I'm sure Klopp would love to just have him about and be able to call on him, but it doesn't feel like the club and the player are in the same place, does it? So.
No, not really. Other transfer stuff, Paul Joyce wrote something for the Express last night. It might have been some of the publications as well, just about our Inns update. Obviously, the common consensus is they want Chilwell, that's the left back they want. Leicester are saying if you want him, you need to pay 10 million. I think we've bid about 6 or 7, including, I think it's 5 plus a bit on add-ons.
Yeah,
Leicester are saying it's 10 million. If you want him, they'll probably end up paying it, I would have thought, if it's that amount of money. The other one is Robertson, the Scottish lad who plays at Hull, who they're looking at as a bit of a backup. Don't know much about him, he's 22, I've just read, so a little bit older, but it looks like they want Chilwell. And then he was. Paul was mentioning as well that there has been a bid for Mane. There was a bid about a month ago, which is quite interesting because that was a time where, presumably, where they were getting less and less confidence about the go-to thing. About a month ago, apparently, a bid for Mane. Just talking, we won, and we're going to have to pay about 30 million for him.
Gotts has completely come out again as well, hasn't he? And said, yeah, I'm staying. I'm not leaving.
So maybe that's why the Mane thing's kind of bumping up as well. I mean, there's a lot of moaning about it, as there often is with Liverpool transfers, really. I mean, but they're not ones that get you really excited.
No, they're not, are they? I think that's the thing. I think we've just been talking about another one that's just popped up out of the blue, not specifically involving Liverpool, obviously, but you'll see the link, is that Raul Morales is going to Bournemouth, apparently, which took me a little bit by surprise. He's 33 now, so it's one of them. But at the same time, you can imagine that if you're a Bournemouth fan, that's a sexy signing, isn't it? That's like a signing that you think, let's go and have a pint, lads. Morales is going to be playing for us next season. Whereas, you know, the signings Liverpool are making, it all seem to be fairly great. The squad's boosted, the squad's better. But they're not exciting signings. I mean, you can't dress them up as anything else. None of them so far are wow. They've got no wow factor about them. And I know people like will play that down and say, well, you know, Liverpool have only got limited budget, this, that and the other. I think it's quite important having that wow thing, and I think back to, you know, when we had Rick Parry in charge. Remember when we signed Harry Kewell, and he talked about getting bums off seats and all that sort of thing. So, you know, there's been recognition in the hierarchy in the past that signing big names gets people excited and gets a bit of a buzz around the club, and I just wonder whether the current people in charge care or about that sort of thing, really, because it feels like we need to get some things over the line, doesn't it? You know, we talked earlier, John's writing something. We talked, didn't we, about how quite a few of the bigger names that we've been linked to, we seem to have missed out on again.
Yeah.
Which is a bit of a Liverpool pattern over the past few years. So it's one of them. It's not exciting at the moment, is it?
Not terribly. And, you know, people could say about, oh, you know, the type of player Klopp wants to work with. But for me, the squad at the moment, it's quite good in terms of strength and depth. It's quite good in terms of 6 or 7 out of 10 footballers, but there's not many 8 or 9s. Mm. And I don't think adding more or 6 or 7 out of 10 footballers is the solution to that, really. But, you know, we'll see. I'm sure we'll all still be ready to go first game of the season, which is August the 13th.
Didn't sound very convincing there about the raring to go. We're going to Tranmere soon.
I'm not going.
I'm going.
Gutman's going.
Gutman, if you're going, mate, and if you're watching this, give us a bell about these tickets, lad. Apparently it's all sorted and I knew nothing about it and it was me that was sorting it. Don't know nothing about it. I want to go, though.
This is a Rob Gutman jump. Rob come into the office and mentioned to Rob about Tranmere. Rob went, that sounds good. And then Rob Gutman left, presuming, from that.
that I'm sorting all kinds of tickets out and buying them, and apparently my son's going, which is news to him as well. So yeah, it's all happening, but yeah, it just didn't involve me.
Get the ferry.
Get the ferry. I might
sell carry.
Yeah. Because my son's not that. He's just not getting that into footy so far, which is a bit of a concern. Yeah, the ferry might do it for him. We'll go across the ferry, mate. I'll buy you a Macca's and then you can watch the Reds. Sounds all right, doesn't it?
Sounds brilliant.
I'd go for that.
All right, we'll leave it there. I put the rider out this morning. We're talking about Glastonbury on that. It's a really good show. We've got probably a midnight caller coming out as soon as I get it up. It'll be about probably up before the video, actually, by the time, because it's more or less all set up to go. That's a midnight caller with Ian McIntosh about this idea about B teams going into the Johnsons, paying trophy. Ian McIntosh has been quite vocal on his objection to B teams in the past, so we just had a bit of a chat with him about that while he's out in France, about what that means and the likely kind of snowball effect from there. And then we're doing another Euro show. We're doing that at 5:30, exactly the time where there's a game of football on, which is planning by Atkinson, as always. So we're going to be talking about yesterday's games while today's games are happening, and then he'll want me to talk about tomorrow's games, them games tomorrow.
So you'll have to go home and watch them on Sky Plus or something.
Yeah.
So
Neil, innit? He's in Glastonbury, he doesn't give a shit. So there's that. So doing that, and then that'll be out sometime this evening. And then that's about it.
Up the Reds.